Hi, I'm Jeremy with DTF Superstore, and these are the three best ways to create a gang sheet. What's a gang sheet? I'm glad you asked. A gang sheet refers to a layout strategy where multiple designs or copies of a design are grouped together on a single sheet of transfer film. With roll film, these sheets can be very, very long. The primary motivation behind using a gang sheet is to maximize the use of material and reduce waste. This can be especially cost-effective when you're dealing with methods where you pay per square foot rather than per design. If you're a company specializing in printing gang sheets and you need a video tutorial for your customers, we're offering an unbranded version of this video for free on our website, dtfsuperstore.com. You can download it, add your own branding to the start, and upload it on your site for personalized touch. We're going to create a gang sheet in Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator, and Canva. There will be separate chapter markers so you can skip to the software you'll be using. All right, let's open Photoshop. First, open Photoshop. Then we're going to create a new file. For our width, it depends on the printer that your printer is using. Most of the time it's going to be 22 inches for 24 inch wide printers, or if someone's using the new Mamaki, it might be 30 or 30 and a half inches wide. And then for our height, we're gonna do 42 inches, but this is totally based off of the length of gang sheet that someone's purchased or that you're choosing to make. Resolution should be set at 300 DPI, color mode of RGB color, 8-bit, and we do want a white background. Go ahead and click Create. Now with the Move tool or shortcut V on the keyboard, we're gonna double check our Auto Select is checked and our Show Transform controls are checked. With these two options checked, it'll be a lot easier to move the different images around the page and to rotate them and all that stuff. Next, we're gonna turn on our smart guides by going to View, Show, Smart Guides, and make sure that's checked. Now we're gonna turn on our snapping. So we're gonna go View, make sure Snap is checked, and then Snap to Layers and Snap to Document Bounds. Those are the ones that should be checked. Next step, and again, this is all just preparing the document for us to start putting in our graphics. We're going to create a layer group. We're going to use the folder here in the layers panel to create a layer group. We're going to double click on the layers group, and that's going to bring up the layer styles panel. And we're going to do a color overlay that is black. You want your opacity set at 100. And basically what this is doing is this is going to put black over all of the graphics that we load in. And you'll see in a moment, it makes it a lot easier to lay them out because instead of trying to see maybe lighter colors, everything comes across as black on a white background. So it makes it a lot easier for us to arrange and make sure nothing's kind of laying over the top of each other. Now we're gonna click Command O or Control O if you're on a PC. And we're gonna select all the files we wanna put in our gang sheet and click Open. It might take a second for you to open up all the files, but let's go to the first one here and we're gonna hit Command or Control A. This selects everything. Command or Control C copies it. We'll go back over to our original document and hit Command or Control V to paste it. Now you're gonna see just a black box, but that's because the image we first loaded in has basically something everywhere. It doesn't have any open space. You'll see on this next one, Command or Control A to select everything, Command or Control C to copy, and back in the original, the new document, Command or Control V to paste it. All right, and now you're gonna repeat this step with all of the documents. All right, now that you have all of your files loaded in, you can just click on them, move them around to arrange them in the way that you see it fitting the best. This is gonna take some time. As you pick and choose, you can rotate your graphics. If you hover kind of over the corner, you'll see that kind of right angle arrow pop up. As you rotate, if you hold down Shift, it will lock at 15 degree adjustments. So it's really easy for it to jump to 90 degrees. So there we go. And we have it snapping to the edges of the document. We also have it snapping to the other images. If you don't have a little bit of a buffer built into those images, you just want to make sure you move about a quarter of an inch away from it. That way it gives you plenty of space to cut between those once they're printed. So I'm gonna work on laying this thing out and then I'll show you the next steps. If there's an image you wanna duplicate, all you do is hold down Alt on a PC or Option on a Mac, click and drag that image and it creates a duplicate of it. The other awesome thing about the smart guide is it lets you know kind of how far away you are from other graphics on the page. Once you have them roughly arranged where you want them to be, you can turn off the layer style by clicking this little eyeball icon here. And now we can see the exact colors and kind of all that layout and exactly how it's gonna look. Like I said, we use this black overlay to make it a lot easier to see where the edges of our different images are. Then you wanna turn off the background layer because we don't want it to print white. We want it to be invisible. And then we're going to export this as one singular PNG image. So we go to File, Export, Export As. And the reason we export as and not just export as a JPEG is we want to verify our measurements, so our resolution. So in this case, we know we're doing 22 inches wide. So we know at 300 DPI, it should be 6,600 pixels wide, and we are. So that all looks good. We are verifying transparency. We do not want a smaller file size. And then we click Export. Name it what we want to name it, and you're ready to send off your gang sheet. All right, let's open Illustrator. We're going to create a new file or new document. We are going to create a document that is 22 inches wide because our printer is a 24-inch printer. If we were printing on the new Mamaki, we might do 30 inches or 30 and a half inches wide. And then we're going to do 42 inches tall, RGB color, and 300 DPI. And let's click Create. Now let's click Command O or Control O if you're on a PC. And we're gonna open all the files we wanna put on our gang sheet. Now click on the first image and we're gonna hit Command or Control A to select, Command or Control C to copy. Go back to our gang sheet file and Command or Control V to paste it. Now we're going to repeat that same step in each one of the files till we have all of our images loaded into our gang sheet. Now, one little quick tip to make it easier to arrange your graphics is we're gonna change the view mode. So we're gonna use Command or Control Y to change the outlines. And what this does, you have to grab it from the edge, but what this does is shows just the outside edges of the graphics. So you're not confused or distracted by any of the stuff in the graphics. Also, if it's an all white graphic, you can see where the edges of that image are. If you feel you need to resize an image, click on the image and here in the upper right-hand corner, this is where you can adjust the width and height to make sure it's the right size. And now we're just going to arrange all of our graphics on the page. If you would like to rotate, hover over the corner till you see this little turning icon. And if you hold Shift, it will rotate at 45 degree increments. So it makes it real easy to turn something around to 90 degrees. And again, just make sure you leave some space between your graphics so you can cut them out. If there's one you'd like to copy, hold down Option on a Mac, Alt on a PC, click and drag, and it'll create a copy. There it is. Once you're satisfied with your layout, if you want to crop, you can adjust your artboard size by clicking the artboard tool here or Shift O, and you can crop your artboard down. In this case, we actually only need about 40 inches. Then when we go to export, we're gonna go to File, Export, Export for Screens. Select your file location, and then in the format, we want this to be 22 inches wide. So we're gonna do a width of 6,600 pixels wide. This is going to give us the appropriately sized gang sheet. And then click Export Artboard. Now let's create a gang sheet in Canva. Open up your browser and head on over to canva.com. Now be aware, to export a gang sheet with zero transparency behind, so a PNG, you will have to sign up for Canva Premium. From the home area, we're gonna click Create Design, and we wanna create a custom size. Set it from pixels to inches, and we're gonna do 22 inches wide. Again, the width of the printer, if it's a 24-inch printer, you're gonna do a 22-inch gang sheet. If it's a Mamaki, which is a 32-inch area, you're gonna probably do a 30 or 30 and a half inch gang sheet, and then height, just whatever you've ordered. In our case, we're gonna try 42 inches. to upload your images to your gang sheet, click uploads. I've got some loaded here already, but I'm gonna load a few more. All right, once all of your files are uploaded, you can simply click on them to add them to the gang sheet. Now, for whatever reason, Canva likes to load the images in way bigger than they should be. So make sure you know exactly what size each one of your images are supposed to be. Go ahead and size those down to the right size. And click add. And repeat the process till you have all of your images loaded. Now that you have all your files loaded in, we're gonna start moving them around and arranging them. To rotate an image, find the rotate icon and you can rotate it like that. Now there's no way to lock it in at 90 degrees, so you just have to look at that little readout to tell you if you've hit that 90 degree mark. Then simply move your stuff around until you get it arranged perfectly. If you want to duplicate an image in Canva, simply click the duplicate icon here or right click and say duplicate or Command or Control D depending on PC or Mac. When you're all done with your layout, you're gonna go to File, and you're gonna go to Download. And here's where you're gonna have your options of JPEG, PNG, PDF. Again, because we're looking to print without the white background, you do want to use a PNG, which is gonna give you a transparent background. Make sure we check transparent background. Again, these options will not be available if you do not have Canva Premium. We do not wanna compress the file. That gives us lower quality. We want the best quality as possible. And then we're going to verify our size. Right now it's saying it's only doing a 2100 pixels and we know we wanna do 22 inches. So let's ramp this all the way up to 6600, which is gonna be 22 inches, 300 pixels per inch, 6600. And it does say increasing the image size means your design might take longer to download. Yes, yes it will. But we want the best possible quality file. Click download. And then you can send off your file to be printed. If you're looking for more tutorials and a better understanding of direct-to-film, consider taking our two-day in-person training, DTF Bootcamp, where we cover everything direct-to-film and take you from a beginner or wherever you're at to a pro in just 2 days. Classes happen once a month, so head on over to our website and see the upcoming dates and register.